So welcome to lecture 3. This is Kulaka Atarik, course moderator for ethnopharmacology, DAP 2102, and in this case this is lecture 3. Shall be speaking about the steps that are involved during collection and identification of a particular plant. So the steps that are involved during collection and preparation of a particular plant for identification are basically 5 steps. So you shall see. So like, once you conduct your ethnobotanical survey, meaning when you conduct your survey, maybe in those particular communities, then you find out which particular drugs that they use to treat various diseases. And in this case, you must follow these steps so that you prepare that particular plant for identification. The first step would be about collection of the plant. Like, how do you collect the plant? Which particular materials do you need when you're going to collect that particular sample, plant sample? Then how do you prepare it? For example, like after collecting, must prepare it. For example, like removing those excess leaves, excess flowers, then the roots, soils. Then after, you have to press it. As you're pressing, you're applying pressure. Then how do you, and then after that, you have to mount it. After mounting it, you have to transport it for identification. So we can start with the first step of collection of that particular plant. When you're collecting a particular plant for identification, that plant should be representative, meaning it should contain all its parts. For example, the roots, the leaves, fruits, seeds. Then when you're collecting, you must take a supplementary photograph. For example, you must use your phone or camera to take this photograph. Reason is that by the time you complete preparing this sample, this plant will always be dry. Maybe this color is important, maybe required by the botanist, so that you can understand maybe if it's another species. Then when you're collecting, you must take the GPRS coordinates of that particular location. Then you must note, you must have a notebook whereby you must write like some important features. For example, like which district, what's the name of you as a researcher that you collected the plant, which medicinal roles does that particular plant play. That's all about. Then, during collecting, we need some implements. For example, like digging, you can use a hoe or you can use a spade for some small plants. If the plant is small and it has some roots, so you don't lose the roots and the rhizomes, you can use a spade. Then you need what we call as sketchers. These sketchers, for them, we use them to remove excess leaves or some excess branches of that particular plant during preparation. I've talked about the notebook, as this is important for you to write some important findings. For example, like in soil type, is it right, low, or it is clay for that particular part where you picked the plant. Then you can also note about the plant availability. Like in that particular place whereby you have collected that particular plant, were there many, it was the only one. Then you must also always consult with the community, sometimes the authority. For example, like some plants may not be allowed to be collected, so you must always consult with authority. Then the other material that we need is the plastic bag. For example, after digging a particular plant, you shall have to put it into a plastic bag to protect it from direct sunlight, which could destroy the plant. Then after putting it in the plastic bag, you have to tie it with a rubber band. That's all about collection. So during collection, you must know about that. What you need always is taking a representative sample. That sample should be really representative, meaning it should contain all its parts, like the leaves, roots, intact. This is an example of when you go to collect maybe at this particular plant from within the field. You must take it with all its parts intact. This is an example of a representative sample. Then the next step will be about preparation of the sample. After you have packed that sample in the plastic bag and tied it with rubber band, what you have to do is prepare it once you reach maybe in the lab or home. And in this process of preparation, what we do is always remove the excess soils. Excess soils, then remove the excess leaves. Because excess soiling will always cause maybe that and disturb the results. For example, this is now after you have collected, then you must put that particular plant in newspaper. When you put in the newspaper, you display almost all features to be seen that you like to be seen for easy identification. Remember, if this process is done poorly, you shall end up with poor results. For example, in the leaves, you may see that the leaves may end up rotting and the identification may be difficult. We put in the major reason that we put the sample in the newspaper during preparation is that to reduce the moisture content of that particular plant. Then the third step will be about pressing. After you properly arranged or displayed those particular features, all the features, then you have to press that particular sample. By pressing, we always apply some little pressure. For example, if you could put that particular plant that you have collected and prepared, put it in some newspaper, then you press, maybe with some pressure, maybe using some books, so that it becomes somehow flat for easy mounting. Then the next step would be about mounting. For example, we have two images here. We have this image one, then we have image two. As a result of these plants were collected, second step they were prepared, then the third step was pressing. But this image two, for it was properly pressed, then you can see the results of proper pressing. But this one, the preparation was poor. We see that there are many stems, the leaves were not even removed. So it gives you a poor sample that it could make even a difference, somehow a challenge. Then after you have pressed, you always use like 2 to 3 weeks of pressing. Then the next step will be about mounting. When you're mounting, now we shall mount that particular plant, that particular sample that we have pressed on herbarium sheet. Herbarium sheet measures 45 by 26.5 centimeters. That's how the herbarium sheet is. It was always like white in color. Then, for example, like here, this is now the herbarium. This is the herbarium sheet. It's measuring 42 by 26.5 centimeters. Then, how do you mount? Like, this is the sample that was collected, prepared, and pressed. You make sure that each of every feature that you want it to be seen, you display it properly. After you have displayed, then you can now add or you can use salt tape to attach those particular parts like we are seeing here. For example, like this is salt tape. This is should be transparent. These are examples of the salt tapes that were used to attach. Then after you have attached, make sure that you label using this right-hand corner. Now this part, you label your name and some details about the plant, in the location, and everything. Then this other corner up, you either use this corner or this corner to make what you call as a seed pocket in case your plant sample had some seeds. This is the seed pocket that we are talking of. On your left upper corner, you try to create a seed corner, a seed pocket. This is an example of still properly collected, prepared, pressed and mounted sample ready for identification. This is like a prior question, like based on your observation on this plant specimen, like prepared well. Yes, it is, as you could see. Then this one was poorly prepared. Really, it makes the identification somewhat difficult and boring for the botanist. So the last step will be about identification of the identification and storage of that particular plant sample. So after you have done all those four steps, collecting, preparing, pressing and mounting, the next step is about identification. So what you do, you take that particular plant that you take this particular plant that you have, this particular plant that you have mounted, you take it, put it into a file, and after putting it into a file, then you can now transport it to a particular herbarium nearby to be identified by the botanist. In Uganda, currently we have a herbarium in Makere University, though the system we are just developing one. So in the herbarium, that plant will be identified by the botanist, then it will be stored. It is advisable that whenever you are collecting these plant samples, you always pick like two samples, because one will always be retained in the herbarium. So the other one would be better, that if you collect two, one will be used for your references. Thank you.